Okay, my dear students, can you hear me? Do you hear me well? Do you hear me, guys, or you don't?
Yes, teacher,
Okay,
I
cool.
listen.
That is great. So, guys, how are you doing? This is our first class, right? First class. So, how is everything doing? Tell me a little bit about yourselves. Where are you from? What do you do? Okay, first, let's have an exercise here, okay? Listen, from a scale from 1 to 5, what is your English level? Okay, what does it say? It says, teacher, I can't hear you well. You can hear me? Wait a second. Wait. Maybe it's because I have this connected here. Can you hear me? Can you hear me or you don't? Better now? Okay.
Sí, profe, creo que mejor, pero igual se escucha como si estuvieras un poquito lejos.
Really? Let me see what's going on. Speaker audio recorder. Why is that? Now, can you hear me? Better or not?
Yes, it's better.
Okay, that's cool. Nice. Let me work on something here. Okay, that's cool. Okay, guys, listen. We have an activity right now, okay? So, easy question. Very easy question. From a scale from 1 to 5, from 1 to 5, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, rate means califica, rate your English level. 1, the lowest, 5, the highest. Give me a number on the chat. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. For example, mine, I would say is a 4. 3, okay, 3. Cool, that's nice. That's pretty good. 3.5, okay, very good. That's great. That is very, very good. Okay, great. So guys, we're gonna have a very quick activity right now. I'm going to share my screen with you guys. Okay. So right now, I'm going to ask you some questions. Okay, easy questions. I want you to go and click on this link. Please, click on that link. Ready? So basically, you are gonna be shown some questions. Right? So, are you following me? Are you with me? So, the first one. There you go. Guys, how are you folks doing? How are you folks doing? Not good? Good? Awesome. Please, I want you to pick one option. Awesome. Really? 100%? You're doing great, right? Good. Everybody answered? Not good? Why? What happened? Okay, cool. So this is interactive, you know? You can answer. Okay? Really? Good. Awesome. You know, good is like, okay. Awesome is very nice, like extremely good. You know, not good. Okay, so folks, it means like friends, you know. Very good. Next one, let's continue on the next one. Where are you now? Me, the teacher, I am in Villavicencio. Where are you now? Please type. Type. Bogota. Okay, we have people from Bogota. Barranquilla. Ooh, Curramba la Bella. That's good. Cali. That's good. Sumapaz. Sumapaz. That is near Bogota? I don't know. I mean, you're in Delhi? Ooh, that's nice. That's really good. Who's in Delhi? Medellin, Soacha. Okay. No more people? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Just 8? So, we have people here from Barranquilla, Medellin, Delhi, Bogota, Villavicencio, it's me. Soacha, Cali, Sumapaz, and Bogota. And so I have two people from Cali. Okay, very good. Excellent. That's nice. So we're gonna continue with the next one. Guys, do you enjoy learning English? And you have an emoji face, you know? So click on any of those faces. Okay, it's good. Okay, cool. Okay, there you go. There you go. So basically, yeah, I think that most of you enjoy learning English. Yeah, it was good. Yeah, from Skype from 1 to 0 to 100, it's like it's good. It's good. Perfect. That it's nice. So I think you're gonna do it good. And the next one is gonna be join the quiz. So now we're gonna go here. What's your English language teacher's name? I miss the name thing. What's your English language teacher's name? My name. Leonardo, Camilo, Oscar, or Marcos? What do you think? Please answer that question. What's your English language teacher's name? My name. Okay, so let's see. Let's see how it goes. Oops, what happened? N. So, what is my name? Leonardo, Oscar, Camilo, Marcos. Okay, very good, guys. Well, actually, you are correct. My first name is Oscar, and my second name, my middle name, is Leonardo. So, you got it right. Very good. Guys, perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Very good. So, this was a very quick exercise, you know, just for you to get to know me a little bit better. Okay, I'm gonna close here. I'm gonna close here and I'm gonna continue with you here. Okay, admit. Very good, guys. I'm gonna just stop this for a moment. Very good. And here. So, guys, basically, what I want you to know, I'm gonna introduce myself. Oh, let's do it a little bit different. Ask me questions. Ask me questions. I'm gonna say my name is blah blah blah. I am blah blah blah. No, I want you to ask me questions. I've talked too much. I mean, ya me duele la garganta, ya he hablado mucho. Yo no voy a hablar más. Now it's your time. But I want you to speak. I want you to speak. Speaking, speaking, speaking. Speak, speak, speak. Okay, Jessica, go ahead.
Thank you. Okay, I have one question.
Yeah, go ahead.
How many years have you been teaching English?
That is a very nice question. I have only worked as a teacher. Like, I'm also a translator. And I think from 2010. So I started in 2010. So it's 2023, 13 years working as an English language teacher. Yes, Jessica, a lot. Long time, Linda. Yeah, I know. Linda?
Okay, what do you like most about knowing how to speak English?
What do I like the most about speaking English? Okay, I would say that actually one thing that I really like about speaking English and other languages, it's the opportunity that I have to meet new people, to know other cultures, traveling. I love traveling. I think it's very nice. So I think English has opened up windows and doors and everything for me. So that is what I really like.
Thank you, teacher. That's amazing.
Yeah. Thank you. More? More questions?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, Mariela. Go ahead.
Mariela, yes. How did you learn English?
How did I learn? Well, actually, it's like a long story, a funny story, because I moved to Houston when I was like a kid, like 8 years old. I lived there for about 4 years, you know? But then, we came back to Colombia, you know? I continued studying. I went to high school here in Colombia, everything. But when I was there, I learned basically how speak it a little bit and maybe listening a little bit, but there were so many things that I didn't know. For example, writing, reading, it became a little bit difficult. So when I finished high school, grado 11, you know, high school, I got into the university. I studied a licenciatura or education. I studied at Universidad Surcolombiana in Neiva. So I basically studied to be a teacher. So when I finished my bachelor's degree, mi carrera universitaria, my bachelor's degree, basically I kind of polished, you know, some stuff. I improved. So that is how I learned to speak it.
Thank you, teacher.
Okay. No problem, hon. No problem. Any other question?
Yes.
Okay, Myron.
Hi.
Hi.
I don't understand the platform well.
No problem. I am going to show you how to go through it today. Basically, this is what this session is for, you know? I'm gonna explain it.
Thank you.
Yeah. So remember, guys, that this session is being recorded, and I'm going to share the recording if I have enough time today, like tonight, or if not, maybe tomorrow. Tomorrow is Saturday, I'm not sure, but for sure on Monday. But I'm gonna do my best to do it tomorrow. Okay, cool. So guys, it's so good to have you here. It's a lot of people I have here. I have Steven, Mariela, Linda, Yesenia, Santiago, Daniela, Myron, Hen, Liliana, Kendris, Paola, Lina, Alvaro, Sofia, Honey, Jane, Andrade, Sara, Diana, and Francis. Welcome you all. Okay, I would love to have you here introducing yourself, you know. And no problem, Steven, it's okay. It's okay, no worries. Look, voy a hablar un poquitico en español. No importa si ustedes su nivel de inglés no es bueno. Si tuvieran un nivel de inglés bueno, pues no estarían acá, ¿cierto? Estarían, no sé, viajando o whatever. O sea, ustedes están aquí es para eso, para aprender, ¿right? Si su nivel fuera excepcional, hay que exceptional, estarían acá, you know, here we are for maybe practicing. Muchos están acá para practicar y otros para aprender. So, it's good. No worries. Okay, guys, so let's start. Let's start. Basically, we are going to talk about, first of all, we're going to talk about the platform. And then we're going to talk a little bit about the course itself. Right? Primero, aquí de ahora en adelante voy a estar hablando en inglés y en español. So, vamos a hablar inicialmente de la plataforma. Ya hablamos de mí, ¿cierto? Aunque no me he presentado. Bueno, aquí voy ligerito. Hello, guys. My name is Leonardo Santos. I am 33 years old. I live in Villavicencio City. I'm not from Villavicencio. I was born and raised in Campo Alegre, Huila, which is a small town near Neiva, which is the capital city of Huila. I studied education, you know, to be a teacher. I work for Sena, you know, online with you guys. I work also for Areandina, Universidad Areandina, and I work for La Universidad de los Llanos here in Villavicencio. You know, my passions are basically traveling, movies, but not watching television. No, like movies. I love going to the movies, you know, to the theater, Cine Colombia, all those theater things. Okay. And I love to work out. I do practice CrossFit. So I love working out. I go to different competitions in Colombia and abroad. So I love it. And I have a dog. Her name is Lola. I love her so much. She's turning 6 years old this year. And that's it. Basically, that's me. Okay? Cool. So, now, thank you. Now, I'm gonna share my screen. Okay. Now, my dear students, I am going to I'm gonna start from scratch, you know, from the very beginning. Voy a empezar desde cero, desde el comienzo. So, the platform that you're gonna be using is called Territorium. Territorium, you know, Sena courses, we work on Territorium. So, it's so easy to get into. Basically, you go to Google or, you know, whatever, and you just type Territorium. Territorium, as it is, you know, cool, that's it. You click here, Territorium, that's it. You have to actually use your credentials, you know, like ID, or cédula, número de cédula, and password, contraseña, and you get into, okay, easy, easy, okay, that's cool. So, I'm gonna get in some of these, here at Sena, we call the courses fichas, right? Aquí en Sena llamamos a los cursos, bueno, tienen sus cursos, pero se conocen como fichas, ¿cierto? Fichas, es el cursito. Look, basically, like, this is English Does Work. That is the name of the course, you know? English Does Work. And you are divided into different fichas, you know, like some of you are in the one that finishes in 53, other people are like the one that finishes in 54, 55, and 56, okay? The content is the same. El contenido es el mismo porque es el mismo nivel, you know, English Does Work 4, okay, 4, this is level 4. So I'm gonna click here, and basically, this is the platform, okay? That's it. Aquí ya entramos a la plataforma. Look, English Does Work Level 4. Questions so far? ¿Preguntas hasta acá? ¿Qué?
Puede mostrar, o sea, ¿esa es la interfaz de estudiantes o la interfaz tuya?
I was gonna do that. So I'm gonna go into student mode. Okay, now the same one. Exactly the same. No cambian mucho. This one is the student's homepage. Right? Esta es la interfaz donde ustedes entran. Tal cual lo ven. Okay? Like that. Okay. So I'm gonna continue. Guys, basically, what you need to know is like the menu, the main menu is in the left side of your screen. I mean, right here, right? Este es el menú. El menú está en la parte izquierda de su pantalla, right? Look, you have so many stuff. You have so many stuff, but guys, you're not gonna need all of them. No van a necesitar todos esos botones. Not really. Okay? So, let me start. So, we have the title here, English Does Work, Level 4, your ficha number, you know, so nice. And this is the menu. It says herramientas or tools, right? So, the first one, it's the announcements or anuncios. So, I'm gonna click. Basically, es donde estamos. You know, basically, it's the same thing. Here, you are going to find all of the announcements that I'm gonna post. Aquí, ese es como nuestro, ¿cómo es que se dice en
social media?
Like a social media en Facebook, like, ¿cómo se pone? La pared, no, el wall, like, yeah.
News?
Exactly, news or feeds in Instagram, you know? So, you call, like, aquí le van a aparecer todos los anuncios que yo les pongo, like, everything. Si quieren información, here, announcements. They are going to be also sent to your email account. Todo lo que yo ponga acá también les va a llegar a su correo registrado en Territorio, o Sena Sofía Plus. Ready? Look, let's check the first one, okay? Chequemos el primer anuncio que yo les puse. It was in Spanish because that was the first one. No quería asustarlos que ya me está hablando en inglés. No, so it was in Spanish. But from that one, like the first one on, all the announcements are going to be in English. Y el primer mensaje para todo el curso, los mensajes van a ir en inglés, ¿ok? Entonces dice, lo voy a leer porque acá está todo. So, mensaje de bienvenida, welcoming announcement. English does work, level 4. Estimado aprendiz Sena, una cordial bienvenida para todos. Les deseo lo mejor en el desarrollo de esta experiencia virtual con el programa de formación complementaria English.Work Level 4 y está el número de ficha. Mi nombre es Oscar Leonardo Santos. Seré su instructor. Recuerden que estoy para ayudarlos y guiarlos durante su proceso de aprendizaje. Me pueden contactar a través del espacio Questions and Concern Forum. Hay un foro, que ya les muestro dónde está, dedicado exclusivamente para que ustedes me hagan preguntas de tipo técnico, que no saben cómo manejan algo, o me hagan preguntas sobre algún tema en específico ya pedagógico, para eso está. O también ustedes me pueden, ok, sigo leyendo, correo electrónico, ahí está mi correo electrónico, olsantos2micena.edu.co, right? O a través del chat dispuesto en esta plataforma. Bueno, ese chat, la verdad, funciona cuando quiere, para ser honesto. En ocasiones se cae, no se cae. Es el que ven ustedes acá abajito. Si ven que dicen offline, ese es el chat. Cuando yo tenga la disponibilidad, yo lo activo. Pero eso se sale, eso se cae a cada nada. Entonces, por eso, no lo uso mucho. So, basically, you can use the email. Pueden utilizar el email. Questions and Concerns Forum. O también la mensajería que tiene esta plataforma. ¿Dónde está la mensajería? Look, here. ¿La ven arriba?
Yes.
There, okay? So you can click there y ahí me pueden escribir. So, important. Esto es muy importante. Guys, it says, este curso inicia el día de hoy, cuando lo envié, que fue el 8, miércoles 8 de febrero del 2023, y finalizará el 13 de marzo. Tenemos un mes, básicamente, un poquito más de un mes del mismo año. Sin embargo, tengan en cuenta esto, la fecha fin de recepción de evidencias, son los trabajos que ustedes nos envían, right? Será el viernes 10 de marzo. Entonces, muchachos, miremos like this calendar. Look, we started here, empezamos el 8, and it's going to be all the way, y vamos hasta, el curso termina el lunes 13 de marzo. Pero el curso termina ahí. Pero ustedes pueden enviar sus evidencias máximo hasta el 10, el viernes 10 de marzo. ¿Por qué? Porque yo debo hacer el cierre, que es el cierre del curso donde yo digo, bueno, ¿quién pasó? ¿Quién no pasó? Yo tengo que calificar lo que ustedes hayan enviado a lo último, pasar el reporte al centro de formación. Por cierto, el centro de formación al cual yo pertenezco se llama Centro Agroindustrial, Centro de Desarrollo Agroindustrial y Desarrollo Pecuario del Huila. Está ubicado en Garzón. ¿Okay? Yo ahí fue donde me contrataron como tal. ¿Okay? Cool. So basically, bear in mind that. ¿Okay? Bear in mind that. So it ends the 13th of March, but the limit or the due date for you to send your evidences, tasks, and stuff, it's the 10th of March. Right? Termina el 13, pero su fecha límite para enviar sus trabajos es el 10. Ya todo está configurado hasta el 10, okay, de marzo. Very good. So, los invito a que conozcan la plataforma haciendo un recorrido por cada uno de los enlaces dispuestos en ella. Durante hoy y mañana, o sea, antier y ayer, les compartiré más información e instrucciones pertinentes para iniciar este proceso de formación satisfactoria. De manera satisfactoria, ¿ok? My name and that's it. So, easy. Good. There are some other announcements. Hay otros anuncios. I hope you have already read them. Espero que ya los hayan leído. Ahora vamos a volver ahí un momentico y listo. ¿Ok? Now, continue. So, we have announcements, right? Participants is like you, like all of the students here, you know? If you click here, you're going to have all of your classmates here, you know, all of the people participating here. You know, you can know yourself, you know, a little bit better, you can chat, you can get in contact and stuff. Information, the next one, basically, it's like what is this course about? You know, it's very important. It's very important. If you read it, ¿quién ya lo leyó y me dice cuál es la descripción del curso? ¿En qué nos vamos a enfocar en este nivel 4? ¿Quién ya lo leyó y me dice?
Pero yo solo me lo sé en español.
Oh, it's okay, no problem. In Spanish too, ya. Yeah.
Pues en el tiempo pasado van a describir cosas como aprender a utilizar el auxiliar del verbo to be, que es el was and were. También a utilizar, digamos, en contextos diferentes como de tiempo, ¿cómo explicarlo? Hacer como comparaciones en cosas pasadas, pero de cosas que puedes estar haciendo o cosas que ya fuiste. O sea, por ejemplo, yo estaba en el salón o yo fui estudiante, cosas así.
Very good, very
También
good.
vi algo como el W question, que es where, when, who y which, pero también utilizándolo como auxiliares, más que todo enfocándose en el pasado, actividades
Very
pasadas.
good, excellent. That's it. Yeah, basically, level number 4 is about past tenses, you know, like simple past, when you want to talk about experiences, you know.
Yo tengo una duda.
Yes.
Esa palabra tense, no sé, o sea, no la entiendo bien. La he visto varias veces y no sé si se refiere como oraciones, o sea, no entiendo
No.
bien esa palabra.
Tense significa tiempo, pero different from time. El tiempo, time, tense cuando hablamos de tiempos gramaticales.
Ah,
El
gracias.
tiempo presente, el tiempo pasado. Yo ahí no puedo decir present time, no, no, no. Present tense, porque es un tiempo gramatical. ¿Ok? Tense. So, basically, we're going to talk about past tense, you know? Simple past tense. That's it. We're going to talk about our experiences, but linked to more formal contexts, you know, like job context, social context, and history. Okay? Now, actividades de aprendizaje. It means what you have to do. Lo que tienen las actividades que ustedes van a realizar. Right? We have basically two. En algunas se subdividen, en otras no. So, evocar hechos acordes con personajes o eventos históricos teniendo en cuenta la estructura del pasado. Hablar de alguien en pasado. Right? Y narrar acontecimientos de sus vidas o de otras personas que ustedes consideren necesarios e importantes. Basically, is that, okay? And the competence, Basically, esa meta, like the goal that you are gonna reach, esa última meta que ustedes van a tratar de alcanzar cuando finalicen este curso, es interactuar en lengua inglés de forma oral y escrita dentro de contextos sociales y laborales según los criterios establecidos por el marco común europeo. ¿Okay? Basically, is that. That's all. ¿Okay? Good. Now, guys. This is the part that you are gonna use the most. Eso es lo que ustedes más van a usar, muchachos. Contenido del curso. Please. One, two, three, four. That is number four in the order. You know? In that order. En esa orden. ¿Tengo alguien por acá? Sí, tengo alguien por acá. Ok. Please. Contenido del curso. I clicked on that. Oops, sorry. Look, this is the most important, right? You must be saying to yourself, okay, si es lo más importante, pero ¿por qué no veo nada? Okay, no worries. Look, you click on contenido del curso, and if you come here, guys, a little bit, you're gonna click, okay, you're gonna have English Does Work, level 4, se repite lo mismo, and here it says project. You click on project. Cliquean en project. Okay? When you click on it, basically you have all of the things that you need. Tienen todo lo que necesitan. Aquí es donde ustedes van a trabajar y van a encontrar todo, absolutamente todo lo que necesitan. Everything. Lo otro que lo que acabamos de ver, bueno, que están que los anuncios son importantes, bla, 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 bla. But here, este es como su libro de apuntes, por así decirlo. Everything is here. Okay, so let's see what it has. ¿Tengo alguien? No. Let's see what it has. So, information, you know, información general. If you click here, guys, and you click again, you know, you're gonna have like a window, like a pop-up window here, you know. It says English that works. Navegue utilizando los botones. ¿Cuáles botones? Estos de acá. Look. You know, one. Two, three. Okay, so basically you can go from one window to another. We have two files here: diseño curricular e información del programa. So I click here, you know, here, click here, and it says diseño curricular. If you click here, you're gonna see the whole content, todo el diseño. Okay, look, English that works. It's 48 hours. This is like an online course. It has like justification, la justificación, bla, 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 you know. Oh, content. ¿Qué es lo que vamos a ver? Oh, a verb to be in past, past form of verbs, a structure, auxiliaries, vocabulary, bla, 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 you know. So, when you have the time, when you have the time, I strongly advise you to read it. Cuando tengan el tiempo, les aconsejo que lo lean. Okay? It's short. So, click on the arrow here. English.word, blah, blah, blah. Now it's información del programa. Look, you have the same information in two different formats: the PDF version and the interactive in way. So, I'm going to click on the Acceder al curso web interactivo. Look, you have a video. Vamos a ver ese videíto. Short, dura un
Estudia English Does Works Level 4. En este programa de formación aprenderás a relacionar situaciones de vida personal con sucesos del pasado a partir de expresiones propias del contexto. Intercambiar información en pasado teniendo en cuenta vocabulario de personajes y eventos históricos, así como el relatar situaciones propias y de terceros en pasado a partir de contextos laborales y sociales. Este programa tendrá una duración de 48 horas y se impartirá en modalidad 100% virtual. Para acceder, debes contar con un computador o tablet con acceso a Internet. Súmate a esta propuesta de formación y haz parte de los miles de colombianos que le apuestan al cambio. Inscríbete en www.cenasofiaplus.edu.co.
Okay.
No, señor.
¿Qué? Excuse me?
No se escucha. No se escucha.
I can listen.
No, you didn't listen? Really?
No, really.
Oh, guys. Oh, I know what happened. Okay, no worries. No worries. You can listen to that later. I mean, no problem. You can listen to that later. No problem here. It's because of my browser. Abrí todo en Safari y Safari no comparte. No lo tengo para que comparta audio. It's my mistake. But we don't need it. Okay? Cool. So, información general is good. So, no more. Now, we're going to move into cronograma. This is key. This is very important that you know this. So, I click here and I click on cronograma. Okay? Look. Cronograma is basically like dates, you know? Son las fechas que se han establecido para que ustedes entreguen los trabajitos que hay que hacer. So, basically, we have here the format. Look, yo pertenezco al Centro de Desarrollo Agroempresarial y Desarrollo del Huila Regional Huila. Okay, it's good. Look, English does work level 4. And here, para acceder al documento, este que ven aquí, si lo quieren descargar en formato PDF, le dan clic acá. Look, if you click it, it's not working. Whatever. So it works. Okay, it's here. Here and do pause for meeting. What is it? What is it? Okay, I don't know what happened. Okay, you click here. And you will get it. You will get it downloadable. Is the browser. Okay, continue. Here, guys, look, here we have unidades, resultados de aprendizaje, conferencias web.
Teacher, please, yes. I can see.
You can see?
Yes.
What's going on?
I don't know.
It didn't work. Now, can you see?
Now, yes, that's
okay.
Fine.
Cool.
Yes.
Nice. Good. So, here you have all the information that you need. So, let's start, okay? Tenemos fechas. So, it says, we start with like a group of activities that we call actividades iniciales. Look, actividades iniciales. We don't grade anything. No tenemos ningún resultado a calificar, nada. Good. Conferencias web. So basically today, conferencia web de apertura, la que tenemos el día de hoy, like this one, okay? It's scheduled for today, the 10th of February 2023 at 2 p.m. Okay? So during this week, durante estas actividades iniciales, what you are supposed to do? You have to work on 3 different activities. The first one, actualización de los datos personales. Okay. Deben actualizar unos datos. Okay. Then, prueba de diagnóstico de saberes previos. No es calificable, ni el anterior. No se saca nota. Simplemente para conocer cuál es su nivel de ingreso. And you have to participate on the social forum. You know, some of you have done it because I was answering some entries, you know, like posting answers. So, some of you have already done it. Algunos han participado. Ya les muestro dónde está eso. Okay, when did it start? Look, empezó el 9, o sea, ayer. Right? ¿Y va hasta cuándo? ¿Hasta cuándo va?
The
12th. The 12th. Del 9 al 12, es decir, hasta el domingo, next Sunday, okay? So, you have this time for you to work on these activities, okay? What is next? ¿Qué viene para las próximas semanas? Look, guys, take a look. Les voy a dejar ahí para que le echen una revisadita, a ver, un minutico para que lean, de alguien que me diga qué es lo que vamos a hacer, what you are supposed to do. Read.
homework.
Very good. Homework.
Homework and evidence.
Evidences. How many evidences do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How many?
Two.
Two? Which ones? I count three. Look. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Like, there is one, like the next group, el siguiente grupo de actividades, right? It's like the activity is evocar hechos acordes con personajes o eventos históricos, teniendo en cuenta la estructura del pasado simple, right? Hay dos resultados de aprendizaje que son como antes, anterior, bueno, ustedes son muy jóvenes, antes lo llamábamos logros, ahora se llaman resultados de aprendizaje. It's two, okay? Relacionar situaciones de su vida personal con sucesos del pasado a partir de expresiones propias del contexto. Y el otro es intercambiar información en pasado teniendo en cuenta vocabulario de personajes y eventos históricos. Right? Tenemos dos sesiones para estas actividades, dos sesiones sincrónicas. I already invited you to the next one. Ayer les envié la invitación de la que vamos a tener. ¿Cuándo? The 14th, el martes. Same time. Y más adelante les envío la del 23rd of February 2023. The same time. Okay? Good. So, in this one, en esta primera sesión, vamos a responder preguntas de la primera actividad. Right? Evidencia de conocimiento. Línea de tiempo, situaciones pasadas. Right? Hay una evidencia que se llama así. And look, es calificable. Se califica. Ahora les muestro qué es lo que tienen que hacer. Okay, cool. When does it start? ¿Cuándo empieza? The 13. When is it? ¿Cuándo es 13? Look, Monday, the 13th. Okay, so it goes all the way until the 26th of February. So basically you have like one week, right? More than 1 week. And then the next evidence, it's photo. You have to participate in a photo, right? Personajes históricos. And it starts the 20th, empieza el 20. When is 20th? It's like 2 weeks from now. And it ends the 5th. Y termina el 5 de marzo. Same here. Evidencia de conocimiento. It starts the 20th and it ends the 5th. Right? Very good. And the last one is otra actividad, otro grupo aparte. Narrar acontecimientos basados en sí mismo u otros individuos teniendo en cuenta el contexto laboral y social. Okay? This is the resultado de aprendizaje. Relatar situaciones propias y de terceros en pasado o, sorry, en pasado a partir de contextos laborales y sociales. We have a web conference the 27th, same time. And the product is video presentación, anecdote. It starts the 27th and it ends the 10th. Empieza el 27 de febrero y termina el 10 de marzo. Okay? Look, fecha límite de recepción de actividades de 10th. Okay? That's it. So basically here at SENA, our criterio de evaluación or grading criteria is just A or D. A, approve, la A, se aprobar. D, no aprobado. Acá no manejamos 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, no. It's A or D. A o de A, G, D. And that's it. So guys, very important. Very important. So, questions so far. Preguntas hasta aquí. Questions.
Tenemos una sesión in the next week, entonces ahí se aclaran dudas, se pueden aclarar.
I'm sorry.
Okay.
No entender.
Sí, we will have sessions in the next week. So in this session, can we have o sea, podemos aclarar dudas y respuestas
before, o sea, antes de entregar el trabajo?
Of course.
¿O es después?
No, of course. Yeah, that is why we have the session. Yeah, the session is for you to ask your questions, clarify any doubt that you have. Yeah, of course.
This platform is very different.
It is not. It's the same one.
No, it's the same. No. Yeah. When I made the first beginner.
Yeah.
The platform was different.
What platform did you work on? Do you remember the name of the platform?
Yes, and the territory.
Territory?
It was very different. Yes.
Okay.
Really? Yes.
Okay. Cool. No worries. But it's easy. I mean, it may be a little bit different, but it's not that hard. Okay, continue, guys. Look. So, according to this, we are right here, you know, from the 9th to the 12th. So, we should be working on actividades iniciales, right? De acuerdo al cronograma, debemos estar trabajando en actividades iniciales, que son estas tres que vemos acá. 1, 2, 3. If you come here, si venimos aquí al menú, debajo del cronograma dice actividades iniciales. So, that is lo que tenemos que hacer. So, you click here, actividades iniciales, good, and you have them here. Look, actividades iniciales, instrucciones. Navegue utilizando los botones para explorar. So, we have the three different activities. Están las tres actividades que deben ustedes realizar. Actualización de datos, diagnóstico de saberes previos y foro social. So, you click here, here, and you will get it. So, actualización de los datos personales. Haga clic para acceder al recurso web interactivo. Okay? So, you click. So, this is the manual. ¿Cómo hacemos esa actualización de datos? Ahí me dicen, ok. Ingrese a bla, 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 bla. Ingrese, va, right? So, put your cellular number, your ID number, and your password, and click on ingresar. Then, you click here. Pues esta es la plataforma, y le damos clic en aprendiz, right? Then, we go to registro, señale registro de persona. Everything is explained, you know? It's so easy. It's very well explained. Okay? That's it. Les tomará 5 minuticos a mucho. Okay? Cool. Now, what do you have to do? Diagnóstico de saberes previos. Look, it's available from the 28th and it ends the 10th. Okay? Él está disponible para todo el curso. Pero traten de hacer las actividades de acuerdo a las fechas que están en el cronograma. Les ayuda mucho a llevar, a no quedarse, mejor dicho, y trabajando con el curso. So, when you are ready, cuando estén listos, le dan clic en ver sondeo. Okay? So, usted está en modo vista de aprendiz, presentación, diagnóstico, you have 1 hour, número de respuestas, 18, okay? Okay, so there you go. So, bueno, a usted no le va a salir así porque pues yo soy el instructor, okay? Acá me salen las preguntas, tan, 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 tan. So you go, presentación, preguntas, complete the following sentences, blah, blah, blah. So you go and complete, okay? Blah, 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 next one, blah, 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 okay? And continue. When it's done, you click on finalizar, and that's it. Okay? Finished. That's it. And what is missing? ¿Qué me falta? Social forum. Okay, so you click here, ver foro, and you're going to be directed to the forum space. Este forum, this forum spot, esa sección de foro es la misma que vemos acá en el menú principal. Es exactamente lo mismo. Si le cliqueo ahí, me va a llevar al mismo lugar. Exactly the same. Look, social forum, Let's see, for example, here we have Maria. Maria says, good morning, class. My name is Maria Jose Ninco. I am from the city of Neiva. Ooh, Maria is also from Neiva. I graduated as an environmental engineer. I'm not currently working because in some places they ask me to speak English. My expectations are to be able to understand and speak English in the best way possible. I commented it, you know, yo le respondí. I was like, okay, Maria. I was like, oh, Maria, welcome to this online course. And, you know, it's like conversations. I strongly advise you to, you know, to create that kind of conversation. It's good for you to practice. Okay? It's good. Okay. Esas son las actividades. Those are the activities that you are supposed to do for the first week. Okay? Simple. Questions. Pregunticas.
Teacher.
Yeah. Han?
I have a question on the activities. I don't know the content is short. Usually I say it for the practice English. And I want to say because the information that you say, wait a minute, please.
Okay.
I want to say, because the information that you give for practice is short for the level 4 of English.
Okay, so basically you say that you want to have more information, more exercises?
Not. I want to say because it's short information.
Why is short information?
Yes.
Why? Okay. Why short information?
I say this because English have many words, have many adverbs. I understand that you give studying the basic for learning in speak practice, but I can say a difference with the level 3 or level 4. I want to know because the information I the short is I want know it.
Okay, so basically you said that like in your previous courses they were longer and they had more information, but now the information is limited, it's short, right?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, I get it. So what happened is like before like last year, courses were up to 1 month and a half. So like 6 or 7 weeks, one course. It was 64 hours. Now courses are shorter. They are not from like made out of 6 or 7 weeks. No. Nowadays, it's just 4 weeks. I mean, 1 month. Right? So basically the content had to be shortened a little bit, the amount of things, but the topics, they remain being the same. Basically it's because of that, you know, before we had more time, you know, but now it got a little bit shorter. So that is why.
Oh,
you know?
So. Thank you too much. No. Yes, I understand you. Thank you.
No problem. Good. So, ayuda. ¿Quién me dice cómo ir de esta plataforma a las actividades previas? ¿Dónde debo cliquear?
You can click on course content.
Okay, very good. Here.
And you can click in project.
Mm-hmm.
So after you can click in actividades de aprendizaje.
Here?
Yes.
Actividades iniciales.
Good. Actividades iniciales. Good. And we are here. Okay? You know, actualización de datos, foro social, prueba diagnóstica. Cool. Now, after that, if we go back to the chronograma or schedule, you know, so we finish this, you know, what comes next? So this, you know, next is the first activity or evidence is línea de tiempo, right? ¿Dónde encuentro eso? Todas las actividades de aquí para abajo, easy. You go back here. After actividades iniciales, you click on actividades de aprendizaje. Okay? We have everything here. So, guys, very important, es muy, muy importante. Like, the first thing that you are going to do is to read the guía de aprendizaje document. It's very important. Lo primero que yo quiero que hagan antes de ponerse a hacer cualquier cosa es que lean esa guía de aprendizaje. That is like the Bible, I would say, for you. Yo siempre digo eso a mis estudiantes. Esa es como la Biblia para ustedes. Like, literally, that is the Bible. You know, it's like the guidance. Step by step. Paso a paso. So, click here. Right? So we have here, the first part is just like, you know, information, blah, 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 blah. Here, you know, we have the, acá tenemos el cronograma, el schedule, you know, the timetable, así a grueso modo, you know, lo que tenemos allá, ya se lo mostré, blah, blah, blah. Acá no hay fechas ni nada, blah, 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 blah. We continue, lo primero que deben hacer, actividades iniciales, you know, good. Ya les expliqué eso, bla, 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 lectura, actividades, bla, okay. I mean, if you have the time, you read it. This is just, you know, information, information, information. And here, okay, look, very important. ¿Qué página es esta? Esta es la página, I don't know. Okay, one page. It says, duración de la primera actividad, look, aquí está. Okay, wait a minute. Okay, yeah. Okay, actividad de aprendizaje de la competencia. Aquí está, interactuar. It's good. Acá me dice que level 4 es como un A2 en el marco común europeo, you know? Está A1, A2, B1, B2, C1, C2. Okay, so it's like A2. And we continue with the activities, you know? So, duración, 32 hours, you know? Materiales de formación a consultar. Ok, entonces para la primera actividad hay un material que I have to study, you know, I have to study. Para desarrollar esta actividad adecuadamente, se recomienda revisar los contenidos presentados en los componentes formativos. When I was young, cuando era joven, and down memory lane, por el camino de los recuerdos. Okay? I have to study that. Tengo que estudiar esos dos materiales. ¿Para hacer qué? Esto. Las evidencias. Evidence. A continuación, se describen las acciones y las correspondientes evidencias que forman parte de la actividad de aprendizaje. La primera evidencia. línea de tiempo, situaciones pasadas. Look, if I go back, si yo me voy back al cronograma, look, dice línea de tiempo, situaciones pasadas. ¿Ok? Para hacer esto, primero tengo que estudiar qué. ¿Qué fue el material que tengo que estudiar? When I was young and down memory lane. ¿Y dónde encuentro eso? Look, vengámonos al menú. Look, when I was young. Aquí está. When I was young and componente formativo down memory lane. Aquí está. Okay? So, clear. Is crystal clear. So, la primera evidencia. Okay, so I have all of the information here, right? Me piden que haga una línea de tiempo. Ahí están todas las instrucciones. Echen la revisa, la leidita rápida, cada uno. Tan, tan, tan. You know? Good. Excellent. We have some examples. Tenemos algunos ejemplos. Look, it could be like this, like that. You know, una línea de tiempo. Good. And something that it's very important. Hay unos parámetros para la entrega, muchachos. Look. Con el fin de elaborar la evidencia de manera detallada, debe realizar las siguientes acciones que se describen a continuación. Trabajar de forma individual. Bla, 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 bla. You have to be, you know, you have to. Eso lo vamos a ver en más detalle en la próxima sesión. You know, but like you can read it. Que debo dar como mínimo 10 eventos, right? La información del aprendiz, bla, bla, bla. I mean, everything. And here we have some online sites that you can use to make, to create that timeline or línea de tiempo. You can use that, you know, everything is there. Todo está ahí. Good. Lineamientos generales para la entrega. Okay, ¿qué es lo que yo debo enviar? Okay, producto de entrega, en qué formato, máximo cuánto, right? And that's it. Good. Now, the next activity. ¿Cuál es la siguiente actividad que yo debo trabajar? Look, vámonos al cronograma. ¿Cuál es? What is it? Oops. Careful. What is it?
Personaje histórico.
Very good. Personaje histórico es un foro. So basically, you have the information.
Es que eso de un personaje histórico.
Y exactly. Es un foro. Entonces, mira, aquí están las instrucciones, qué es lo que debe tener el foro, bla, 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 bla. All is very well detailed. You know, so this, y está la siguiente evidencia, evidence, video presentation, esa es la última evidencia, por ahí me comí una, look, video presentation, you know, look, so as you can see, guys, como les comenté hace un momento, as I let you know, guys, guía de aprendizaje is like Bible for you, okay, la guía de aprendizaje es como la Biblia para ustedes, I mean like, all the information is there, step by step, step by step, step by step, okay? Está todo ahí, todo explicadito. Okay, and the material, the learning material is here, you know? Like when I was young, down lane, things I was doing before, you know? And that's it. Let me check one. Vamos a chequear uno de esos materiales para que más o menos lo conozcan, okay? So it says, when I was younger, click here para acceder al recurso. So you click there. Look, it's there. Okay. Introduction, verb to be in past, like see content, time expressions, let's talk, synthesis, and there is a video. Hay un video. Yo sé que no lo escuchamos, but look, you can play it, you see, and explain, like it explains everything, you know? It's cool. And that's it. That's basically it. Well, So far, questions. Questions so far. Preguntas hasta aquí. Questions so far. No questions? All good?
No, teacher, all is okay.
All is okay, all is clear, okay? Look, question. I know that there were some people who had some questions about how to move around the platform.
It's okay.
Good. Sé, al principio, había algunas personas que me dijeron, hey, profe, es que no sé cómo moverme en la plataforma. Quiero que me digan si aún tienen dificultades para entender la plataforma. Please. Or is good.
It's good.
It's good. Okay. Great. So, I'm going to close this here. I'm going to... Yes?
¿Yo puedo saber cómo me fue en la actividad de saberes previos?
No, really. If you want, you can text me. I mean, you can send me an email and I will let you know. But you cannot actually see it. Right?
Como tal, okay, no, thank you.
Ya, yeah, como tal, no puedes ver como tal ahí, pero si tú quieres ver de pronto respuestas, me puedes enviar un email y yo te comparto.
Vale.
Okay, cool. So, now we go here. It says, después de haber estudiado esto, right? Vamos, aquí hay dos casillitas. Dice, actividad de aprendizaje 1 and 2. Vamos a ver qué hay acá. 1. So, it says, okay, instrucciones. Básicamente, aquí ya está el grupito, right? Como viene en el calendario. Look, this is the calendar. You know, look, the calendar. So, the gray one, la que está en color gray, gris, it's la uno, and the white one, it's number two. Viene el grupito, look, línea de tiempo, foros y cuestionario. So, look, línea de tiempo, foro y cuestionario, you know? That's it. So, I click here, básicamente están agrupadas, ¿no? Línea de tiempo. Click aquí para acceder al anexo, clic aquí para ver pues, qué es lo que hay que hacer, ¿no? Entonces, clic here y acá tengo más explicación. Básicamente me repiten lo que ya leí, no me repiten lo que ya leí, me dan instrucciones extra. ¿Qué debe tener esa línea de tiempo? ¿Right? Es como una lista de chequeo. ¿Ok? ¿Presenta de manera efectiva el ejercicio que se le pidió? Si es sí, entonces tiene el 30% de la nota. Evidencia un uso adecuado de expresiones temporales y el verbo to be en pasado, yes or no. Emplea el suficiente vocabulario para hacer referencia a sus sentimientos, las etapas de su vida, bla, 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 yes, no. You know, and basically, that is the score. You know, approved, not approved, okay? And that's it. Basically, that's it, okay? ¿Cómo la envío? Sencillo. Look, when it's ready, cuando ya la tengan ustedes hecha, so you click here. You know, viene a pasar, fecha de entrega hasta el 26. Si miramos el cronograma, let me check, look. Look, línea de tiempo de 26. Okay? And that's cool. Okay? So, click here, ver evidencia. Basically, look, you click here, si es para agregar un archivo, si quieren escribir algo, tienen que agregar un archivo, ok, adjuntar un archivo, ok, le piden un PDF, un PDF, ok, you click there, you adjust it, and that's it, ok, and that's it, and you click on contestar, simple. That's it. And basically, that is it, you know? So, contenido, proyecto. Okay, that's it. The same with activity number 2. If we continue here, we have sesiones en línea. Okay, here you're gonna find the links to access, right? Aquí van a encontrar el link de acceso a las sesiones en línea. And here you're gonna find the recordings. Y acá dice grabaciones. Esta está siendo grabada. A más tardar, voy a tratar de hacerlo mañana. I'm gonna try to do it tomorrow, Saturday. No sé, no se trabaja, pero voy a tratar. If not, on Monday. Okay? Van a encontrar las grabaciones. Look, enlace de sesiones. Tenemos la de hoy, opening, and la del próximo martes, que ya está creada. Okay? You click here, and basically you got the announcement. Tiene el mismo anuncio que les puse en la carpeta de announcements. You know? Simple. That's it. Okay? And recordings, we have anything here? Aún no tenemos, por eso no hay nada. Okay? And finally, we have the last one, is very important. We have documentos de interés para el aprendiz. You click here. Ay, no lo puedo ver porque estoy en modo profesor. You're going to have some documents there. Those are for you. Let me get this off a little bit. Oh, shoot. What's going on? Yeah. Doesn't work. Okay, here. Okay. Okay, contenido, proyecto, documentos para el aprendiz, and that's it. And you're going to have some documents, right? Algunos documentos, like que Sofía Plus, guía de buen uso de foros, okay? It's very important, el uso de mayúsculas, reglamento del aprendiz, important, derechos y deberes del aprendiz. ¿Cómo descargar un certificado en Sofía? Manual para el aprendiz sobre el manejo del LMS, que es Territorium, Learning Management System, you know? So you have those resources. And that's it. That is it. Okay? That is the platform. No sé qué otras cositas se me estén quedando. What do you want to know, guys? ¿Qué preguntitas tienen? What questions do you have? Please. Questions.
Teacher, I have a question.
Yeah, go ahead.
During the process, we can see the calificaciones in the plataforma.
Yes, in the platform. Yeah, you can do it. Actually, I'm gonna allow it again. There is a section on the main menu. It says calificaciones. Let me show you. Look, it says calificaciones, okay? And you will have all of them here. Lo Leonardo Santos, pues no he hecho nada, no tengo calificaciones. But you can see them, okay?
Thank you, teacher.
You can see them, yeah, in calificaciones, okay? Calificaciones. Important, it says evidences. Here, you're going to have all of the evidences. Aquí van a tener las evidencias. A excepción del foro. ¿Ok? Del foro y de la prueba. No van a estar ahí porque tienen otro formato. So, it's not there. ¿Ok? That is why, por eso les aconsejo 100% trabajar siempre por contenido del curso. Ahí está everything that you need. Todo lo que necesitan, a excepción de los anuncios. ¿Ok? Oh, nice. So, no more questions? All good? Nice? Excellent. That's great. That is nice. You wanna play a game? Do you know Kahoot? Good. So, let's play this game. And with this game, we can finish the class, okay? If you have any questions, feel free to ask me. So I'm gonna copy this. I'm gonna go on here. Please click here. Click the link. And I'll be waiting for you here. Yesenia is here. Francis is here. Diana is here. No more people? Really? I have like 13 students. Come on, guys. I'm waiting for you. Paola. Liliana, Linda.
Teacher, yeah. I have continued with the problem with connection.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, hon. So, we're gonna start, okay? We're gonna start in 3, 2, 1, go. What is the rest of the people? No more people here? Let me see how many. 19. I have 19 students. Okay, let's go. Let's start. Claudia is here. I like your emoji, Claudia. That is like a very smart unicorn. Okay, there you go. First question. This is general culture, cultura general, you know, everything. So it says, what is the coldest place on earth? The coldest, el lugar más frío, the coldest. Alaska, North Pole, South Pole, Antarctica. I think it's Antarctica. It's Antarctica. Very good, excellent. Next. So, first position, Daniela. Next. What is the longest river in the world? Ooh, there are a lot. So it's the Amazon River. Very good, the longest. Very good. Next. Okay, Daniela is still first place. On what continent is located Ecuador? Well, that is easy. In what continent? In America, continent. Es el continente americano, no el continente suramericano, Central American. No, it's America. Very good. Good, continue. Next. Where did the Olympic Games started? ¿Dónde empezaron? The origins of the Olympics. Oh, that is easy. That's not even fácil, it's very easy. It's Greece. Very good. Next. Daniela is still here. Okay, how many bones are there in the human body? ¿Cuántos huesos hay en el cuerpo humano? How many bones are there in the human body? It's 206. Very good. Next. When did World War II end? ¿Cuándo terminó la dos? En el 45, I guess. I think it's on the 1945, but I'm not sure. Yes. Good. Paola is going up. Very good. Next, who is the author of Don Quixote? Quixote in Spanish. That is easy. Miguel de Cervantes. Very good. Let's go with... It's 50. Son 50 preguntas. Vamos a completar las 10. Okay? Next. This is number 8. Who painted The Last Supper? O La Última Cena. Very good, Leonardo. Okay, let's go with number 9. Santiago is here. In what country is the Tower of Pisa? The answer is Italy. Very good. And the last question. Ooh, almost. So, what is the name of the multiplication result? What is the name of the multiplication result? Yeah, the product. Yeah, I was doubting it. Okay, cool. How do I end this? I mean, I wanna end it before. Next. So, through rounds. I can't. I think I can't. So, we're not gonna go the 50. We're gonna stop here. So, first place, no podemos ver el podium, because no sé cómo ended it, no sé cómo, okay, board score. So, the first place is Daniela, very good. You got first position, Daniela, very good, nice. Diana Cardona, second position, good as well. Paola, third position, nice, Paola. Santiago, you got fourth position, which is good. And Linda, you got the fifth position. Congratulations, right? Para el resto, congratulations. Thank you very much for participating. Okay, cool. So we're gonna finish here. I'm sorry. Hit the page. Okay, guys. I hope you have enjoyed. Para terminar, quiero hablar un poquito en español. Algunas cositas. Entonces, muchachos, darle la bienvenida al curso. Recuerden que eso es educación virtual. Ustedes tienen la plataforma Territorium disponible 24/7. Ustedes verán a qué horas entran, ¿cierto? Hay un cronograma establecido. Muchachos, pónganle cuidado. Todas las actividades están disponibles hasta el 10 de marzo. Sin embargo, hay unas fechas de cierre para cada actividad de acuerdo a ese cronograma. ¿Qué quiere decir eso? Que si una actividad termina el 26, ustedes pueden enviarla después del 26 porque están habilitadas con entregas tardías, pero no pueden superar el 10 de marzo. ¿Cuál es mi consejo? Mi consejo es que ustedes trabajen según al cronograma del curso, porque pasa mucho, como saben que tienen hasta el último día, dejan todo a lo último y no les alcanza el tiempo para enviar las actividades. Me ha pasado bastante. ¿Listo? Recuerden que terminamos un viernes. Yo básicamente lo que hago es lunes, domingo, matarme ese fin de semana calificando todo y enviar reportes de una vez para que el último día sea mucho más suave para mí. ¿Listo? Entonces, siempre yo les aconsejo, trabajen con tiempito. Muchachos, hay un foro. ¿Cuáles son los medios de comunicación? El foro que se llama Questions and Concerns, preguntas e inquietudes, está ahí abajito del foro social. Pueden acceder a él a través del menú principal que dice foros. Ese foro es para que ustedes me hagan las preguntas que consideren necesarias, tanto tecnológicas como metodológicas o de conocimiento. ¿Listo? El foro. Correo electrónico. Ustedes ahí tienen mi correo electrónico. ¿Okay? O mensajería de la plataforma que ahí les mostré, donde estaba en la parte superior, hay un icono de un sobre. Esos son los tres métodos de comunicación. No manejamos WhatsApp, no manejamos ninguna otra forma de comunicación. ¿Listo? Recuerden que la opción de chat nunca la utilizo porque es que se craquea mucho, se daña mucho, casi es muy raro que tenga un funcionamiento óptimo, entonces no la utilizo. Los tiempos de respuesta. ¿Sí? Tengo 24 horas desde el momento que ustedes me envíen un mensaje para responderles en días hábiles. Si me lo envía el viernes a las 6 de la tarde, yo tengo el lunes hasta las 6 de la tarde para responder. ¿Listo? Para calificación, se deben calificar entre 3 días hábiles de haber enviado ustedes cualquier trabajito. ¿Listo? Para que de pronto también tengan ustedes un poquito de paciencia. Yo tengo cuatro grupos, son 320 estudiantes. Entonces, es bastante. Entonces, paciencia. ¿Listo? Y nada, yo estoy aquí para colaborarles. Cualquier cosa que necesitan, me lo hacen saber. Yo con mucho gusto les colaboro. ¿Listo? Thank you very much for coming. If you have no questions, we can finish the class today, okay? Thank you very much.
Teacher,
No
thank you for your time.
problem.
Thank you, teacher.
Yeah,
Thank you, teacher.
my pleasure.
Thank
See
you
you
very much.
next
Okay.
week.
Bye bye.
Bye bye. Take
Bye.
care. Enjoy. Bye.
Thank you.